Hey, we just checked on him, and so those that can't be here, we'll make sure we get up to speed. I know there's a lot of activities happening today with the old university building. I believe Chamber also has an event, so I'm hopeful that we can get through most of everything today within 50, 55 minutes. Should be hopefully a quick meeting. By the way, welcome. My name is Mario Canizares. I'm the city manager. We're going to flip the lights. That way this can easily be seen because of the lighting. So this is the kickoff of the comprehensive land use plan. We had a very similar meeting yesterday afternoon, the same time here in the city room with the downtown plan folks. So I think we lasted about 55 minutes, so no, you know, just a challenge. If we can stay in that time, that'd be great. But really today, it's just kickoff, get started, and go through, hopefully, I'm sure you know each other. And if not, it's the opportunity to kind of get to know each other, just kind of going around the room. And really today is just to kick it off, hand off some materials, and get started. Okay. So here's kind of our itinerary for the day. So we've got our welcome, we just did that. One of the things I'll ask you all to do here shortly, if you can obviously state your name, how long you've lived in Nacogdoches, what do you do as a profession, or what you did do as a profession. And then while we're here, if you have time, you should have some sticky notes at your place. We would like to get just to come do a little exercise. I don't have to do it while you're speaking, but certainly jot it down. If you can write down two or three things that you love about our community, it could be about downtown and just community in general. And what are two or three things that you think we can improve upon? And as you leave, we would ask that you take your sticky notes and just put them on the large board that has the heart and the little board that has the slanted face there with upset. So we're just taking that. We did the same thing with downtown folks yesterday. And so what we'll do is we'll capture all that, bring it all back to next time we meet, and just kind of share it with you. And again, not to really dwell on it, but just see what people are thinking, just kind of get things so. Itinerary, we're going to do introductions. We're going to cover the responsibilities in charge of this committee. We did the same thing yesterday. Just the governance, so really fairly simple. We will review these materials that you have before you. Just really very cursory review, not a whole lot of time, just see what, so you know what you have. And then at the end, we'll certainly open it up for some Q&A. I know Ken is out at the moment, but he should be arriving shortly. And then before we depart, see if our Ken and or she will say anything at the end, since they have been appointed as chair and vice chair. Okay. Let's see. So why don't we go around the room and start introducing each other? And if we could, maybe we start out with Mr. King, if you don't mind just telling us who you are, what you did, and how long you what you do for a living, and then how long you've been in our community.
I'm Larry King, not the guy from television. I always tell my students, I teach at Stephen F. Austin. I always tell my students that I don't make as much as he makes. I haven't been married as many times as he has, and I think I'm better looking than him.
His name.
Been in Nacogdoches. I was born in Nacogdoches. Went away, came back. This time I'm here about 22 years. Closer to about 19 years. Yeah, that.
You're looking at me like you're done. My name is Kurt Sutton, and I was born in Nacogdoches in 1965 in Memorial Hospital, and I feel like I know about half the people in here fairly well for a long time, and then there's maybe another quarter or so of you that I know sort of well, but I have lived in Nacogdoches all my life except for very short time that I was in college and lived in College Station, went to Texas A&M University. And then I came back and I've been in the lumber manufacturing business ever since. So I'm looking forward to working with you guys, seeing what we can do to make Nacogdoches a better place.
I'm Paul Jackson, and I moved to Nacogdoches. My family moved here when I was 6 years old. Here was except for when I did a tour in the Army. I stayed in California for a couple of years. I worked for Burke Center for 44 years, and I'm a retired counselor. And of course, I'm interested in doing anything we can to improve the community also.
Well, I'll try to be not so long. I'm known for speaking too long. So I got to East Texas. I'm from Eastern Kentucky, but I went to West Africa in the 60s, right after you were born, as a missionary in Liberia, and then did graduate work and language study in France, and went to open up our social work in French West Africa. And there I met, you got to watch these charming East Texas boys. That I married an East Texan in Ouagadougou, which is north of Niger. And we traveled around. He was with the State Department. We traveled around for 30 some years in Africa. You may wonder what in the world I'm doing here with this, but my work has been as a director of an international school in Mauritania. It's in the Congo. We spent 10 years, and I helped put back a country that was completely no seed crop or anything that was left, and trying to keep the people with AK-47s out of the way, helped evacuate people out of Chad when they were all threatened to die. So I'm good with emergency things if you need help, and if you need money and nobody wants to give it, I can usually get it. So for me, the most important thing that I did here, I do a lot of things, but you might wonder why somebody from the Federation of Women's Clubs here. The building is important, but what is really more important about that building is that people from all, there are 20 some groups that are all working together. We all have different ideas about politics and all that kind of stuff, but we work together on a common goal. And I believe that that's one of the reasons that Nacogdoches is busy putting up statues instead of taking them down, and everybody trying to work together. So that's me.
Well, my name is Brad Maul. I teach filmmaking at SFA, but I graduated from SFA in 1974. As a theater major, and I've been back here for 17 years, and I live on Mound Street, so I've really become involved preserving the history, finding out about the history. I'm pretty much enamored with the Caddo Indians and their time here, and I really love what this town represents and the feeling of the 300 years here. So that's why I'm here. I want to help preserve the history.
Hi there, everyone. My name is Juan Gonzalez, and I am a branch manager for Bancorp South Bank. I was originally born in Mexico. My parents migrated to East Texas, to Henderson. Attended junior college and graduated, and then a transfer to SFA. I graduated from SFA in 2000. I have worked in the financial services industry since then, 5 years in Tyler, 10 years in Houston, working for Chase and Bank of America. And then the family was getting a little bigger, wanted to be closer to family, moved back to Nacogdoches. I now see Nacogdoches from a different point of view. When I was a student, you kind of have tunnel vision and you just kind of focus on school. But now as a community member, I'm really looking forward to looking for ways that I can help out the community.
Now come back.
Oh. Come back.
No, let's go to you. Right now.
My name is Mashara Delaney Fields, and what do we say?
Oh, just introduce yourself.
And I'm the Chief Diversity Officer at Stephen F. Austin State University, and it's a real pleasure to be on this committee to help serve, because although I'm not from Nacogdoches, born and raised in Houston, so have the experience of the Metroplex area, but the opportunity for growth here is evident. And I think that having that here, we will touch a lot of lives and be that premier city of East Texas, and not just think of Tyler when you say East Texas, but really put Nacogdoches on the map. So I look forward to working with everyone.
Well, I'm Nicole Ivanzik. I moved here from Mississippi about almost 7 years ago. My husband got a job at SFA, and so I followed him, of course. I'm here representing the Parks Advocacy League. We're just trying to build a better relationship with the city, and hopefully my experience on the park side will come over toward this. And also I work at SFA as a contracting specialist in the Procurement and Business Services Office.
You are familiar. We were on Zoom calls together.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Carrie Charlie, the Executive Director of Campus Living, Dining, and Auxiliaries at SFA. I too love history. I'm from Marietta, Ohio, which was the first settlement in Northwest Territory. So a lot like Nacogdoches, I've been here for 2.5 years, in Texas for 13 years, and lived in Boston for 13 years as well.
Ned Poole. I've lived here almost all of my life. I was born Mike Curt at Memorial Hospital, educated in the public school system, moved away to go to college, and worked away for a few years, and decided in 1986 this is where I wanted to live. So I moved back, raised 4 children here. The 2 of those children have chosen to move back and live here as well, both of them SFA graduates. I'm excited about the committee. I'm excited about what it brings. I'm a real estate broker by trade, owner of Charles School Real Estate. I was given what I consider a great deal as a child growing up here, and I think it's time to give back. So that's why I'm on this committee.
I'm Kathleen Bellinger, and I was not born here. I was born in St. Louis, and my husband was born in Louisville, but we, after graduate school in Austin, we both decided that rather than to go and take jobs, he had lots of offers and I had several offers, and rather than to take jobs for the job, we decided to choose where we wanted to live. And so we chose Nacogdoches. And that was about 2,000 years ago. It was actually 35 years ago. It was a long time. So even though we're not bins, our children are. And we have loved living here. Most of my work I have taught at SFA for almost 30 years. I'm what's called a professor emeritus. I still have ties. And I've done a lot of work. When we started our master's in social work program, there was very little literature, very little understanding about rural communities. So I was helped to get a better understanding even nationally. So I've done a lot of work nationally with rural communities to help them. And it is so, I'll get choked up here, but it's so humbling to be here. I'm very humbled to be here with all you brilliant people. And most of my work here in Nacogdoches has been kind of quiet on purpose. And now I find myself out in the middle of stuff. It's very weird. I hate pictures and all that. And now I have to do all that. But anyway, I'm happy to help in any way I can. And I just really look forward to everybody's ideas and contributions. Thanks.
I'm Sydney Kroll Register. I was born in Nacogdoches. I went to school at UT and said I was never moving back here, and lived in Austin. I did my graduate work at Baylor. I'm a clinical psychologist, said, and we lived in Austin for about 15 years and then had a son, and driving in traffic for that long and never getting to see him was just terrible. And so we moved back here. My dad owns a bunch of land out of north of town, so he bribed us by giving us an acre to build a house on, and here we are. Our quality of life is so much better. My friends in Austin, they're always trying to beg me to come back, and there is nothing they could ever say to me to get me, frankly, to go visit them half the time. My son goes to Christ Episcopal. My office is less than a mile away. I can see him all the time. So I've really just kind of come to really appreciate Nacogdoches. So I'm excited to, the last place I lived was Georgetown. And that's the town I always hear when people are saying like Nacogdoches can be like, so I'm familiar with what Georgetown did. We can be way better than that.
All right.
My name is Denise McDonald. I have ties to Alabama, but grew up in Illinois. Ended up coming to SFA and staying, met my husband and got married, and we raised three girls, and they're all, well, two of them are pregnant now. One just had a baby, so I'm about to be a grandmother three times over. I work at our church, Austin Heights Baptist Church, and at my husband's office. And I'm happy to be here too. Excited about this possibilities here.
I'm Jacob Lusk. I'm the Director of Career and Technical Education for Nacogdoches ISD. So from the lens of a Career and Technical Education Director, I'm really excited to see the direction that we're looking at from a city perspective in the future. I'm not from Nacogdoches. I grew up in Ennis, Texas, just south of Dallas. Something that's really drew me to this committee and to serve on this committee is that Ennis, similar to Nacogdoches, and I believe they've gone through this similar process a few years before we are. And so seeing the impact that a committee like this to re-envision what the city is and what it offers, the quality of life in my hometown has drastically improved over the past 10 years. And so I'm excited to do my part to bring that here to Nacogdoches.
Good afternoon. My name is Mabel Cannings, and kind of have a convoluted story also, Marilyn. I met an awesome man from Guyana, South America, about 44 years ago. His name is John Cannings. And he decided that he wanted to come to this university called Stephen F. Austin State University in Nacogdoches. And I said, NACA what? And, you know, we took the trip and we relocated from Dallas to Nacogdoches. I had earned a master's in urban studies and urban planning. And so I started my career, my public service career as an administrator with the city of Fort Worth. And then I moved here and worked for DETCOG, the Deep East Texas Council of Governments. And I was one of their regional planners there. After coming from kind of an entrepreneurial family, my dad had been an entrepreneur for years in the kind of grocery business. That bug hit me, and I launched my hospitality business in the travel and tour sector. I soon came to own my own tour buses, and I began to escort people kind of around the world. I'd customize and create the tours. And I did that for about 25 years. And then I eased into the events planning and PR side of the business. And so now I do take on a few projects helping nonprofits raise funding and helping them plan their events to raise funding. And I'm not doing a lot of that any longer. I'm 70 this year, but I do a little. I love working in the community, and I hope I can use my experience to help this committee with some comprehensive planning.
My name is Kim Beppish. I'm a local attorney. I'm also the current chair of the Planning and Zoning Commission. And previously, I was on the Historic Landmark Preservation. And so I applied to be on this board because I think it's important that we get this process right. And I'm excited that we have such a broad cross section of the town represented on the steering committee. Really excited to work with all of you and get to know you better. I'm originally from Ohio. Well, the other side of the state, Toledo, and from Cary, and served in the Navy for about 9 years. Got out, went back to law school in Austin, and have been here since 2012. We're here through family. My wife's family is from this area. She's got roots going way back in the Cushing area. So we loved it here and loved the environment. Second, with Dr. Register over there, got to say about living in Austin. So there's a lot of things about Nacogdoches that make it just a wonderful place to be. And make our goals, figure out how to preserve that while giving our kids opportunities so they can stay here if they like and not have to go to Austin for jobs. So anyway, also again, I'm Steele Wright, Director of Marketing with TFP Nutrition. And I've been in Nacogdoches, born and raised here and been here 30 years of my years. And representing Medco as the vice chair. And you know, when it comes to economic development, our family came here in 1930, and 15 decades the company was created thanks to the city welcoming us in. So talk about spearheading economic development. It's pretty expensive. But essentially the 8 years I wasn't here, I was in Dallas, met my wife there. She's as well. Looking forward to working with you all on this committee, and it's an honor and privilege to be here with y'all and have the ability to make an impact in our community best way we can.
Thank you. So you also noticed there that we have a SFA student representative. Take care, Marilyn. We'll see you. She's not leaving because she's mad. She's got another appointment at the PA with Ole University building.
Ribbon cutting.
Yes. And so you'll see an SFA student representative with a TBD to be determined. When the council had made those appointments, it was obviously a finals week. So we don't have a person named yet. So we'll work, reaching out to you, Carrie, to see if we can find some student or sure. Find some student representatives for both committees. And so that way they can be here to serve and represent the student voice. Obviously, the intent would be to go into the community, to the university community, to get their input, and be able to have that input directly on the committee itself. So and then we've got a couple of absences. We'll make sure that those folks that couldn't be here, we'll get them up to speed as soon as possible. We do have some staff liaisons that we'd like to make some quick introductions, and we'll start out with Lena Helton.
My name is Lena Helton. I'm the city planner and director of planning and neighborhood services. I'm also an East Texas native. Got my undergraduate and graduate degree from SFA, and I've worked in other communities. Was a city planner in Lufkin for a couple of years. My first planning job. I then moved to Frisco, Texas, which is just north of Dallas in the DFW area. Really enjoyed working there. The traffic was horrific. So actually moved to College Station and was in College Station as their planning manager for a couple of years, and then made my way back home. So I just kind of did a full circle. I finally had the opportunity to come back and jumped on it. So I'm very excited to be here, very excited to be part of this process. And that's.
And then we've got folks in the back. We'll start with Steve Bartlett.
Steve Bartlett, I'm the director of public works and city engineer. I'm glad to be here to offer technical support. Spent much of my career in private practice before I came over to the city. In fact, was one of the authors of the current comprehensive plan. So I've kind of been watching this and working with it for a lot of years. So we're looking forward to being able to reformat this and move forward with a new plan.
I'm Brian Gray, I'm the Community Services Director, and I've enjoyed every one of the 18 years that I've lived here.
I'm Jessica Thal, I'm the Community Services Assistant Director and Main Street Manager and Historic Sites Manager right now. I've been in Nacogdoches since 05 when I moved from Fort Worth to go to SFA here. Met a Nacogdoches boy, never left, so it's worth everybody. I'm also the staff lead for the Downtown Master Plan Steering Committee, y'all's kind of sister committee. So y'all will see me in and out every now and then.
Okay. I'm Brown. I am the president and CEO of NEDCO. I've spent my entire career here with the city, started when I was an intern in 2000 and moved around a little bit within the city, and now I'm over at NEDCO and I'm excited to work with y'all.
My name is Juan Paulette. I work in the Planning and Zoning Department as a planning technician. I'm originally from Port Arthur, Texas, but I moved here as quick as I could.
Hey, my name's up there, again, city manager. I'm similar to Juan in that I came to Nacogdoches as a student, so I had a different perspective back in the early 90s till 95 when I graduated. My wife graduated from SFA as well, so we're both lumberjacks, and 25 years later, I came to be the city manager here, and so I've been here just been shy of 15 months, and so looking to do with my property and build my family fully established here in Nacogdoches. So if you don't mind, sit down. That way I can actually read my notes. But I want to take some time, again, briefly, to just kind of go through the committee's responsibilities and charge. And while I know all of you can read well, I will just kind of go through, hit the high points of the charge. And if I apologize, read every more than a lot of probably just because of nerves. And so, and one thing I did fail to mention is this meeting is recorded. We have a camera, you do have microphones around the table. The meetings are being recorded. They will be recorded going forward. That way we have that online available for those that couldn't be here because they're just absent. Committee members, but also available for the public. I know it's important to the council for full transparency. So we will be recording these meetings going forward. So just wanted you to be aware. Apologize. So if any of you, and I'm sure most, if not all of you, have served on a variety of committees, one of the mainstays of a committee is just having regular attendance. Obviously, life happens. Things people are busy. They're involved with a lot of different things with work, family, other activities, or other commitments that you have, and understand things do come up. But attendance is important. And that was important to us. So just obviously, engagement and being part of the process is huge in these things. And while I'm doing most of the talking today, just because we're kicking off. After today, I hope not to speak much unless asked. And so really, beyond today, it really is the committee's process. And so really, we'll rely heavily on the chair and the vice chair and their absence to really facilitate the discussion and call meetings to order and again, keep order in the committee. So again, this is just really to kick things off. Obviously, the reason we're here is because we represent a community, represent whether it's a constituency group, a sense of people, or just the fact that the ties that you have within the community. You are here because you represent a group of people. And so because of that, you all stay connected. And you have those connection points. So again, this is important in the planning process because this is all about obtaining input from our community. Along the way, as we get started in this process, as concepts get brought forward, ideas get brought forward, the intent is that those ideas, those concepts get distilled through this process, through this committee. And ultimately, through this process, you all will be making recommendations to move it to the next level, whether it's for staff to do something, whether, again, if we do get working, do begin working with a consultant, for the consultant to move something forward. This is important for this committee to have that, obviously, that input and get that process moving to the next level. Again, you'll be making recommendations, reviewing plan elements along the way as needed. The other thing, too, is as a host, while we don't necessarily expect you to do everything for us, but because you do have those connections in this community, you can open doors in areas that we just can't, and certainly consulting can, but there's just things that you can do for us that we can't. And so again, if we're going to obtain community input, then you know we believe that we need to go in a variety of communities that just because we'll be strangers, they're not going to necessarily be very open to us, but you have those connection points and you can help facilitate those locations, those audiences, so that we can make sure that information. So we hope that you will help us with that and again promote it so that an audience comes and provides the input that we need to obtain throughout the process. Again, very similar populations, there may be situations where there may be a language barrier, and so we may need some help with that or just who knows what the case may be. Just those harder to reach populations that maybe just because
whether they're scared because of the pandemic or they're just can't get out because of just physical limitations, maybe. If you have those ways to get those people connected, we need to know those ways. And so that way we can get their input as well, because that's hugely important. And while I really doubt this will be an issue with this committee, but and just like I don't think it'll be an issue with the next committee, it's possible that issues may come up, that the juices may be flowing and people get spirited, but at the end of the day, it's all about maintaining the quorum. We all are community members. While most of us know each other, when we walk out of this, we're still part of the community. And this is what we hope to come out of this, is to have what's best for Nacogdoches, but we should be able to walk away, hopefully, everyone getting along. So any questions before I move on to the next slide? Okay. So committee governance. So this past Tuesday night, on the 7th of December, the council officially appointed you all, just like they officially appointed the other committee. This committee is 20 members. The other committee is 19. So they're, you know, it's 39, almost 40 people participating. So those are good sized groups of people. And it's really interesting to see everyone's background and their time here in Nacogdoches, whether you're been here all your life. It's just fascinating to hear everyone's the personal and professional backgrounds. So they did also appoint the chair and vice chair. Ken as our chair and Steele Wright as our vice chair. Just keep in mind that just like with most any committee, they don't have anything as far as a vote or influence. They don't have any more influence or less influence than you all. They're there just to obviously keep things in order and so that we can stay efficient with our time and use of time. So but they did make those appointments on Tuesday night. All meetings are open to the public. I will tell you that today's and yesterday's meeting, we weren't sure if council was going to go ahead and appoint everyone. While we obviously invited you all, we did not do a true posting of this like we would for normal meetings. But going forward, all future meetings, since we're going to hopefully talk about a schedule, all future meetings will be posted like we do for all public meetings. So all meetings are open to the public. So that's why you see behind me some chairs for the audience, but there will be, it will be posted for an open. The quorum is again a simple majority to conduct business. So you've got 20 people participating. You know, again, like I said, life happens and we have absences. And so, but there will be times where we may need four people, but once we hit a quorum, we need to start because we've got business to conduct and we've got schedules to keep. And again, respectful of everyone's schedule. So a quorum is a simple majority to conduct business. And again, it is what it is. As you see, Councilmember Bellinger is obviously introduced herself. And so you see council members that are part of the process. So they are here as resources. And they themselves talked about this on Tuesday, that they're part of the process, but they themselves don't want to dominate the process. And so but they want to be engaged, be here, and be participants along the way. And so we've got Councilmember Bellinger, Councilmember Bolden on this one, on this committee. We have Councilmember Fisher and Councilmember Anderson on the downtown committee. And the mayor is not participating in any of these things, Mayor Hines. The council decided that consensus is a method in which these committees will operate to move ideas forward. Again, consensus is not intended to be unanimous agreement, unanimity. Consensus is a general concept of in a process in which there's general agreement to move something forward. We understand that there will be ideas and concepts that not everybody will 100% agree with, but hopefully there are a majority of things that people can agree with. And the things that we don't, or the things that you don't agree with, this is an opportunity for folks to discuss it. And let's kind of delve into those matters and try to find appropriate solutions so that we can move things forward, if that makes sense. And so again, that's why it's so important about that input, everyone allowing to speak, hopefully coming within with an open mind and having flexibility. And at the end of the day, I think we all agree that we want what's best for this community. We want our community to not only thrive today, but we want to thrive for the future. So I think everyone can agree with that.
And it's just a lot of times detail those elements. It's how you get there. Along the way, as ideas and elements continue through a process, this committee, just like the downtown committee, will start making recommendations. And as you do, the intent is, depending on where it goes and where things reside, it will be forwarded to the Planning and Zoning Commission. The majority of the ideas that come out of this process will go to the Planning and Zoning Commission. It's possible that it could go to the Main Street Board. No different than the downtown plan components would go to the Main Street Board, but there are some elements that would go to Planning and Zoning potential. I don't know what those may be, but that's possible. So again, those ideas, those recommendations would go to that respective board. Those boards would then obviously have public meetings, public input, discuss it amongst their board members, and eventually make recommendations to City Council. And then ultimately, City Council is the one that puts it into policy, puts it into place, if that makes sense. And then the final piece of the committee governance, and we'll cover this short, just very briefly, and you'll see this in the resolution. One of the things that was important for council, and important, I think, in the community because of just discussions and conversations that have been held for these many months, is accountability. And so the concern was, is we have existing plans and have those existing plans been put in place or put to work? And what has and what hasn't been put to work? And so that's important, and that's obviously needs to be done. And so it's very possible that whether it's this committee or an amalgamation of other committees, maybe it's smaller, the intent is once our work is done as a group, that there may be an accountability or an oversight committee. So as goals are established from these plans, that whether it's this committee, another committee, or how it's reconstituted, that there is some level of accountability and oversight. So as elements are created, and there are some goals and objectives as they're established, that staff works towards those goals and objectives, and it's run under that lens, sure that those goals and objectives are in. And if they're not, there needs to be a rationale to it, whatever that may be. So, but there is that component in this committee. So it's not that this committee will just be done and it's dissolved, but it may be constituted in some form of fashion to hold this, to keep that accountability. Any questions before we move on? Okay, rocking along. So we are reaching towards the end, believe it or not. So I want to be respectful of everyone's time, but I do want to take a moment because, again, this is to pick off. We're here just to share information, and in future meetings, start pulling up our sleeves to start the work. But one of the things I do want to go through with you is just very briefly go through some of the things that we're giving you. The very first thing you have is this thick binder that's the complement. This is the comprehensive land use plan that was adopted in 2003. It's important for you to have this. It's important for you to, at some point over the coming weeks, to please read it and get understanding about it. There's been a lot of talk in the community about what a comprehensive plan is. And so the important was to make with the downtown master plan. The downtown master plan was adopted in 1974. And so we've given that committee a copy of its plan as well. We want to make sure we have a copy of this because, again, it's important. The other thing is that we have is you have a binder, another binder that is not as heavy. And I can go really quickly through this. What the intent here is to have you have plenty of information. So, over time, be probably adding more to it. And so we'll have copies of information available for you, OPOTs, or add to it. Certainly we can email it to you, whatever your preference is, we'll do both. That way you have a full set of documents. So under tab one, you've got all the staff contacts that most of the staff contacts that were here today. So that way you know firsthand who everybody is and how to get a hold of everyone. So you have that. Under tab two, you have committee. So I make sure that before you leave, if you haven't signed in, that you please sign in, because it's important to have to make sure that we have your correct contact information. So if there are, if there is erroneous information, a spelling, a wrong email, because we do, you know, obviously have typos, or if we have outdated contact information for cell phones, please let us know. Please write it down, rip it out of your document, of your binder, give it to us on your way out. We'll make sure we update that, and we will provide you enough data with that, so that way everyone has contact information. Okay? Behind that, behind your contact is a resolution that was adopted by the City Council. And again, that's just to keep that, just literally to keep behind that, just under tab two, is a resolution that the City Council adopted that basically constituted both committees and I would like to point out two things. One is, as I mentioned, under the page one, under the last whereas, where at the conclusion of the planning process, the council may reconstitute a plan oversight committee. That's what I was telling you about. That's just enumerated in the resolution. And then under page two, I believe under section two, originally we had placed in there that if a committee member withdrew or needed to leave because, again, job change, they're moving, or it's just they just can't handle the workload and they've got to withdraw. Originally, we had in there that we would not replace that member. Council decided that no, that they needed to be that person needed to be replaced. And so, again, we expect all of you to stay with us. We understand that things do happen. And so if someone does need to withdraw, then staff would work as quickly as we can to try to find a replacement for that individual and get that to council and get them up to speed as soon as we can. Okay. So that's under tab three is just a list of plans that are in play. And so really for this meeting is really the big binder that I just mentioned to you, the downtown committee. It is the one from it says 72, but I believe it's 74, and then some other small types of designs and small plans that have been done. So we did not have copies of all that yesterday, so we'll have copies of most of those documents that we have on available for them next Monday. So just wanted to let you know kind of all the list of plans. Under tab four is just a timeline of when we started this process. We started this process almost a year ago to the day, last December. These discussions, you can see all the various timeline and key just things that we've had for the last nearly 12 months through this process with both CAP and CAP. Just wanted to let you have that just as part of. You've got a copy of the presentation, and what you have is literally the combination of the presentation that's given today. You have above you, and also the same slides that we used yesterday. It's basically the same slide deck, with the exception of intro slide and the committee slide. But you can also at least see who your committee members are on the downtown. The 19 people's on there. And so there will be a lot of, there could be some overlap, but again, you can see who those participants are that are working in the process. Any questions so far on the binder or the materials that we've given? Okay. So the next piece is trying to come up, see how consensus works with this group, is trying to get it in a time that everyone. You know, we got 20 people. They're busy. We know that. And trying to find a time that's meaningful for most people to meet. What I enjoy about working through committees is consistency, to be able to pick a day of the week and preferably a time of the day. So that way we kind of know a set schedule when we're going to be meeting. I will tell you, the committee, the downtown committee, they were able to kind of rally around that first, but then again, just kind of throwing this out at you. They chose the second Wednesday of the month to meet, starting at 3:30 p.m. That way they allowed folks to try to get out by 5:50 so they could attend to family and other other events that they've got going on in personal lives. So my hope is when we meet going forward, that these meetings are about 90 minutes long, maybe 2 hours the max, if we, but try to mark it and end it and adjourn around 2 hours. And if there are things that, that need to be discussed that we couldn't get to, we'll make sure that it gets brought forward at the subsequent meeting. It's very important that there will be, there may be subcommittees that are set up that go tackle a specific issue, a smaller group of folks that meet, tackle a specific issue, get input, and then that group would then, that subcommittee would then bring it to the full committee for discussion and feedback going forward. So again, I'm not saying Wednesday, the second Wednesday, but I'm just saying that that's what they chose, the second Wednesday of the month at 3:30. I don't know if this committee would want to meet on that day, either early or later than that, or would you prefer to meet the day after and then on Thursday? I will tell you, obviously weekends probably no go. And so I assume you'll want to avoid Fridays. And so I don't know if Thursdays around this time helps at all, or a little bit earlier, to try to keep it to about 3:30 to 5. At the max, maybe 5:15, 5:30, or something like 5:30. But anyway, I just want to throw that out that they did choose the second Wednesday to return. Thoughts, ideas? Anyone?
Mondays and Tuesdays are really hard because of the other committees and things. Right. So Wednesday, Thursdays are much better for me, I know.
So is Thursday around this time, or even Thursday at 3:30, okay?
Yeah, 3:30.
Sorry.
3 might be a better time if we're planning on.
Okay.
Maybe a couple hours.
Okay.
Ariel, I was going to propose maybe the third Wednesday at 3:30. What? Of the month, kind of like a week after, maybe same day of the week and same time, but Thursday's okay for me. What else?
Other thoughts? I'm sorry, Kurt, and on the Wednesday, what time?
3:30.
Okay.
In other words, it'd be identical to the
other
downtown committee, except this would be the third.
No, yes,
the month.
At the same time, now that would keep this consistent.
That's where I was going there.
Well, maybe we don't land on that today, but is there any thought? I mean, is there a preference? Either one works.
Either one.
So a Thursday. So if it's a Thursday, would it be the Thursday right after the committee? In other words, say the second Thursday. Does that make sense? If that would work, or the third Wednesday, so either one, okay.
Second Wednesday of every month, I'm occupied 2:30 till whatever the meetings are. Third Wednesday is the CBD board.
And those are in the afternoon. So potentially the day after the second Thursday.
Wednesday would be that.
Is that, for the most part, general consensus of the group that Thursdays around 3:30, depending on the agenda, would work?
Okay.
Yeah. Anybody have a hardship with that?
3:30 is a little better.
Yeah.
3:30?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, actually, you're good. I'm going to cover that in the next bullet, and then we'll talk about that. So on a consistent basis, I was thinking we would start in January. Okay. So we've got our date down, so the second Thursday at 3:30, and we'll get that, make sure that everybody has that going forward, so we'll get that. And in fact, probably we'll send that out, and more than likely, again, I don't know if everyone uses electronic calendars on your phone, but you may be getting like a Microsoft Outlook invitation just to have it, and that way it hits you in different places. We are going to, in one of the emails that we had sent out a couple weeks ago, we had talked about having a sort of a, obviously our kickoff today, having a meeting scheduled on 13 just to kind of do an overview of planning. One of the original reasons, one of the original thoughts was to have the consultant we were looking at proposing the council come to the committee and work with the committee. The council had different of opinion about not bringing the consultant on at that time, and that's perfectly fine. And so what we decided to do is we kind of pivoted on that and reinvested. And so what we're hoping is instead still have our meeting because it's already been called, and for the most part, people can attend. But it would be, again, not facilitated, but it would be started with our chairs in mind. So again, that takes a back seat. Certainly, I always take a back seat. But the intent would be to really start doing a deep dive and working towards what this document's about. I will tell you throughout the several months that we've been discussing this, there is different levels of understanding what this document is and what's been done, what's been going on. If I think it's important, the planning and zoning fairly knowledgeable what's going on, but you have people that really haven't touched it at all. So really, I think we're going to do is take the next few months and really work closely with staff. We are still looking at recommending the consultant go forward in January, and that's what the council is. What we think is important is to start really working with the committees, with staff, and start kind of getting everyone on the same page. And so what we would like to do is Monday start highlighting key sections of the document. We're likely to give you a homework assignment to read the document over the course of the holidays into the time that we meet next time in January. I believe that we'll be looking at doing some kind of exercise, but just really some of the key elements of the plan. And even really just trying to get an understanding from each one of you. What are the things that are important for you through this process? I know somebody articulated that, but really what are the key goals? What are the key objectives, key priorities that you want to make sure that not only this committee, but whether it's a consultant or the staff, we make sure that we adhere to. So we start articulating that, and then the committees start kind of working together. It's important for council, at least another on Tuesday, is that the committees work together in addition to just meeting and introducing each other, but really work together on a task. And so the hope is to get a good understanding of these documents, of these plans, maybe even go through an assessment of the plans, figure out what's been done, what hasn't been done, what were some of the goals and objectives that we were able to accomplish, and with the things that we weren't, and try to provide a reason why. And then out of this process, then it'd be forwarded to the respective committees, whether it's the Planning and Zoning Commission or the Main Street Board, and allow them to also review it, provide input, and ultimately go to council and then be presented to City Council. So that way we can say everyone should be on the same page on as far as what's been done in the past, and that way we can start looking forward into the future about how we can move our community. So that's what we have going on the 13th. This committee, this group will be here at 11. We will be providing a license, probably sandwiches and drinks. So again, obviously we're still be on a working lunch, so we will be providing and really outside of that, those are mostly my comments. Does anybody have any questions or discuss anything further? Will we turn it over to staff in the back? Am I missing anything? Have I forgotten something to say? Again, I'm gonna put you on the spot, but I don't know if you or Steele would like to just say anything or just hear your last years to the group.
Yeah, and I know y'all are probably, it's 4:59 for something. Y'all are probably putting up short in this. First of all, just want to thank you for your willingness to serve on this committee with the goal of trying to shepherd the planning process and make sure that we're addressing the right concerns and getting the planning consultants, whoever they may be, focused on the right tasks. I do think that it is important to figure out where we are with the 2003 comprehensive plan and the status of our current planning, and to see how efficient or acting, and maybe we'll start ahead on a new process. I think that's a great idea. I want to make sure that there's going to be a variety of opinions in the room, I'm sure. Hopefully we can disagree politely if there is any occasion to disagree. Though that being said, I do want to make sure we get everyone's opinion. And so please feel welcome and empowered to speak up if you have an idea, even if it seems maybe like it is not the, the common consensus, because there are things in these types of committees where we are not considering every opinion, and we really come up with a better product if we're, everyone's allowed to freely speak. And of course, if there's ever anything that would, anyone feels uncomfortable about, let's discuss it, either myself or I guess I'll be Steele's this as well as vice chair. Feel free to come talk to us about it. We'd be happy to address that as well. Anything you think that we could be doing better or that we need to add to a meeting, again, feedback can go directly to us. You can email, you can text us, however it's convenient for you. You know, we're excited. I'm excited to kind of get started on this process. I've been worried about our dated plans for a while now. I think this is going to be, you know, a important milestone. 20 years from now, people will look back, I hope, and say, and here's all the great things that happened because we planned. So I'm looking forward to that.
I mean, to kind of play off of what Ken said so eloquently, you know, we're all here for Nacogdoches, and I know that everyone has priorities. Looking forward to being a listener, listening to what those priorities are, listening to what I'm hearing you say, listening to what I'm hearing you not say, trying to bring to light those things that aren't being said, finding what's actionable, you know, discussing what's not actionable, and essentially just getting to the root of, you know, what is this comprehensive plan all about? Looking forward to being on that journey with you.
Thank you. Anything else? Have a great evening. Thank you for being here, and we will see you Monday.